Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now in this tutorial series, I will show you how you can sign in passwordlessly to Firebase in the help of Swift 5. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, let's just see what we have here and make sure that you have your phone ready because we are going to send a magic link to our device. And it looks like we have some sort of trouble here, but I do have the test installed there, so I would just tap on there. And as you can see, we have a sign in button, and let's just tap on there and add in our email. And then let's just click on send magic link. Okay, now we can open up our mail app. There we go. And as you can see, we have an instant no reply from testing passwordless sign in. And I will tap on that. And you can see it says click this link. So let's tap on there and it's working. And there we go. You have successfully signed in with your email, and that is okay. And of course, we can sign out if we wanted to. Okay, that is what we are going to build out in this tutorial series. So let's just jump right into it. And first of all, make sure that you download the resources from the link below in the description, and you will see something like this. Colors assets, a helpers folder with all of our helpers files, a pod file, and a root view controller, and a sign-in view controller. This is just a basic setup, so I don't waste time setting all of this project up. So let's just go ahead and create a brand new project. Go to Xcode's file, new, and project. There we go. And I will select my single view application that is, you can find that in my tutorials. And basically it just eliminates the main dot storyboard. So let's click on next and I will name this. Okay, let's click on next and let's drag and drop it onto our desktop, wherever you would like it. And I will choose my videos. There we go. I will create a GitHub repository for that, so you can, of course, take a look at it on our GitHub repositories. There we go. Okay, now what we want to do first is add in our pod files. So let's just close all of this, maybe minimize the test project, and open up our pod file. Okay, let's just drag and drop all of this onto Xcode. And as you can see, we have four pods there. So let's navigate to our code that we have just created and open up terminal here and type in cd and a space and just drag and drop the root folder and hit return and type in pod init to create the pod file. And then you just drag and drop the pod file onto your Xcode icon. And there we go. Here we have our new pod file. And all I will do is simply copy all of the pods from the example, from the resources that you have downloaded, and add it right over there. And one more thing, let's comment that out, and the platform should be iOS 12. So that is it. Let's close both of these and run pod install in the terminal. Okay, it is analyzing dependencies and it's downloading, and this may take a while for you depending on your internet connection. And once this is done, a new Xcode workspace will be created, and we will use that Xcode workspace from now on, because yeah, we are using CocoaPods. So let's do that and open up our newly created Xcode workspace, and let's add in some more resources here. First of all, let's just double check that we do have that pod file and we do have those pods. Great. Let's close that. And what we want to do here is, first of all, let's delete this root view controller, because we are going to replace it. And go ahead and take a look at your resources. and you will see a root view controller and a sign-in view controller. So let's just simply drag and drop both onto your project. Make sure copy items if needed is checked, create groups is checked, and of course your target is checked. So let's click finish there, and both of these Swift files should appear real soon. And now let me just maybe add in our assets, so the for the colors. So there we go, let's drag and drop that under the assets catalog. So let's click on finish there, and as you can see, some files are also missing, and those are in the helpers folder. So what I'm going to do is create a new group here. So let's create a new group, and I will name this new group helpers. There we go. And I will add these helpers into that folder that we have just created. Okay, pretty awesome stuff. Okay, let's just wait for those to be populated in and there. And maybe I will just simply drag that all the way down, maybe under the assets catalogs. Okay, one thing that we are going to do today is to create an app in App Store Connect, because frankly, we will need the app ID that we are going to get by creating an App Store Connect app. And for that, we are going to have this bundle identifier that we have created being registered on the App Store Connect. So let's just simply enable in-app purchases. So Xcode makes its thing and creates our app ID or bundle identifier in the Apple developer portal. And I believe we can safely disable that. So we are going to just wait a few minutes now, because it's not automatic and instant. Okay, till then, let's just hit Command B and see if our project builds up correctly. And hopefully it does. Let's just wait for that. Until then, let me just talk about these helper files. Well, we have our hot file. Basically, we are displaying information about the status of the app with the hot, like, okay, we are signing up, we are saving our data, and so on. Under service, you will see that we have an auth state. And basically, the auth state is an auth state. Auth state is a part of Firebase's Firebase auth, so that is why we needed to import that in here. And we have two types of auth states, signed in and signed out. Of course, we are setting the default value to signed out, because yeah, the app needs to check when it launches if we are signed in or signed out. Now, pretty straightforward. Now let's go to setup. You are not going to use or modify anything in these helper files, except maybe for the key of the Firebase Open App Dynamic link. We will talk about that later on. Otherwise, these are just keys you are not going to modify. Here we have our UI alert service. That is a UI alert controller helper that has some real helpful show alert functions. And finally, we have a UI application extension that grabs our topmost view controller that is needed for our UI alert service. And if you noticed, the project built out successfully, so that is really, really nice. And now it's time to create our app in App Store Connect. So open up your favorite browser and go to App Store Connect. And let's create our app there. Let's just log in here. And I will use my secret password there. And let's go and select our team. And you will see that we will shortly have a plus sign at the top left corner of our screen. But of course, we need to enter my apps to do that. So let's just wait for it. And let's just create a new app. Okay, and let's see if we do have our bundle identifier. If you recall, that is called com Rebeloper Firebase passwordless sign in. So let's see if that is already available. So under choose bundle ID, let me just make this so you can see all of the screen. So let's choose, so Firebase maybe, or let's see Xcode. This is that. Okay, so Firebase passwordless sign in. And I will make the platform iOS, and it will be Firebase passwordless sign in. Okay, so let's choose our primary language now, and it will be an English US. And let's just paste this name for the SKU, and I need to delete the spaces here for the SKU. Full access is okay. So let's create it now. And after a few seconds, your app will be created. And let's just wait for that. And there we go. Here we have our bundle ID, and here we have our Apple ID, and we will use that in just a moment. So what we need to do that next is to go to the Firebase console, and let's create an app for this tutorial. So click on Add Project. And again, it will be Firebase passwordless sign in. I accept the terms. Let's click on create there. And it is creating our project. And with that, we are going to finish for this video. But in the next one, we are finally going to set up everything that you need to do in the Firebase console, because there is a lot to do. So once your project is ready, click on continue, and you will be taken to the get started page of Firebase console. So that is it for this video, and I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of the second video when it comes out, because we are going to, of course, set up everything in the Firebase console. And yay, Firebase! Okay, I will see you in the next one.